Hello, amazing people of God. The good Lord bless you. The Lord has put another takeaway in my heart for you this beautiful week. And it's from the book of Ruth, chapter number 4. I will read verse 6 in context and I will tell you the story. But I have prayed for you. I pray for you that it will not be a week of regret. That, oh, had I known, you will never regret. You will lose no favor that heaven has planted along your way. But out of blindness and stupidity and carelessness, many people do lose privileges and opportunities that God has brought their way. Ruth chapter 4 and verse number 6. Hear what it says. And the king's man said, I cannot redeem it for myself, lest I mar my own inheritance. Redeem thou my right to yourself, for I cannot redeem it. The story is this. When Naomi came back, Ruth came with her. Naomi had been a woman of great bitterness of soul and spirit, because in her sojourn in Moab, she had lost everything, lost her children, lost her husband, and only Ruth came back with her. And Ruth was ripe to remarry. And it was the tradition in those days, Boaz, who connected with Ruth in a very particular way, you can enjoy that story when you read it, brought the elders, 10 of them, to the gate and said, look, our brother Elimelech had died in Moab, but he has a piece of land that the next of kin should buy. And in the hierarchy of things, it was just the next to the most entitled person. The most entitled person, the Bible did not give us his name. He just said he was a king's man. He was the most entitled. And Boaz offered that piece of land. Initially, he said, oh, yes, I will take it. And when he said, look, if you take it from Naomi, you also will take Ruth with the piece of land. Then he said, no. I don't want to impair my own fortune. I don't want any albatross. And fancy that this was the same woman, Ruth, that became the progenitor of the Messiah. Oh, what an opportunity this man lost. I pray for you this morning, you would lose no opportunity. This man threw an opportunity that will have put him in the map of the world forever as the progenitor of Jesus Christ, who came to save the world, but he lost it. He lost it because of very careless considerations. Hear him. He said, I cannot redeem it for myself, lest I mar my own inheritance. He thought by acquiring the land and acquiring Ruth was going to mar his inheritance. But nay, Boaz seized the moment, and by Ruth, he became the progenitor of the Messiah. The genealogy of Jesus, you will see that it was Boaz that begat Obed, and Obed begat Jesse, and Jesse begat David, who was in the lineage of Jesus Christ. You will miss no opportunities this week. By carelessness, by the things that you do not fully understand, you will not miss it in the name of Jesus. That's my prayer for you. And I know you want me to rim that down with prayer. So you will seize every opportunity that heaven will place on you along your way. You will not be short-sighted. You will not be little-minded. Your mind will not be so little. You will not be myopic. But your mind will be broad and versatile and open to receive all opportunities that will come this week. You like that? Let's pray together. Righteous Father, I pray for your children. I pray that none will be like this king's man. King's man whose lot it was to be the progenitor of the Messiah. He lost it. He lost it out of short-sightedness. I pray, Lord, that your children this week will lose no opportunities. Thank you, righteous Father. I know you have heard, because we pray with thanksgiving. In Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. Amen. I'm going to be with you again next week. I ask God's blessings on you. I ask him to bless you and to keep you. And I say bye-bye.